Hi everyone, it's Lisa Mears. Thank you so much for joining me today. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you some brand new slimline storage products. These are from Totally Tiffany. I have the Totally Tiffany magnetic sheets for the slimline dies. These magnetic sheets come in a pack of 5, so they're perfect for storing your slimline dies because the white side of these sheets is a magnet, so your dies will stick onto these, and when you put them in the pockets, you will be able to keep everything together in place. And you'll see me demonstrate this in just a few minutes. So you get a pack of 5, and then next I want to share with you the 9x4 tab divider pockets. So these pockets are perfect for storing your slimline papers, your slimline dies, your slimline stamps, and the magnetic sheets fit perfectly in these pockets. And these are also a set of 5 that come in a pack. So you can see how you can take your magnetic sheet and you can slip it right in these storage envelopes, and they all fit perfectly inside there. So it's a great way to organize your dies. But of course, you can use these envelopes by themselves. You don't have to use them with the magnetic sheets. You can just use these envelopes to store your papers or your stamps and any type of slimline product that you might have. It also comes with these labels that you can put here at the top of the pocket to label your items that are inside. And then I also want to share with you the slimline storage box. This is the Fab File slimline storage box from Totally Tiffany. And once you put this box together, you can store all of these pockets and the magnetic sheets inside of the box. And this box comes with a set of storage pockets as well. So if you're not familiar with Totally Tiffany's storage boxes, they are a very sturdy plastic and they hold up very well for storing your craft supplies. And I'm going to show you here how to put one of these boxes together. So the boxes actually come with some score lines, and I'm just going to fold the plastic at the score lines to just make sure that it's folded really well. And then once I start folding at the score lines, I'm going to start being able to put this box together by taking its shape. So here I'm just folding down at the top. This part is the lid. And then I'm just going to bring this bottom portion up and kind of fold the sides in. And this is going to form the structure of the box. So next I'm going to fold the score lines on these tiny flaps on the side. So on both sides you have these small tiny flaps. Just fold those in. And then you have these little tabs. And these are the tabs that are going to go inside of the sides of the box so that it connects together. And these just basically snap in place. So you just put these little tabs in the slots and you have 2 on each side. And they basically just snap right in. So here I'm just gonna put this tab in. You can see how easy this goes through the slot, and then the actual base of the box is put together. So now I just want to show you how these storage pockets with the magnetic sheets, they fit perfectly inside for holding all of your slimline supplies. And then you can close the lid, and the lid does have a little flap on the front that you can tuck inside. The box also does have a handle, which I'll show you that here in a little bit. So here is a slimline background die. I'm just putting it in the storage pocket with the magnetic sheets. I also have some extra scraps, and you can see how the scraps will fit perfectly in back of the magnet, and you can pop that right in your storage box. Here is another slimline die that I have, and I'm going to organize this on my magnetic sheet. So the white part is the actual magnet on that magnetic sheet, and then this die actually comes with several other dies. So you can see how you can just put all of your dies that go in a die set together on this magnet, and then you can pop it in the storage envelope and then store all those dies together inside of the storage box. If you have several background dies like I do here, these are some scrapbook.com background dies, I can just pop them all in one pocket, and you can save some space by storing several dies in one pocket. And then here are some slimline stencils from Lawn Fawn. I'm just going to slide these in the envelope so you can store all your slimline stencils in here, and then pop that in your storage box. They fit perfectly. The slimline embossing folders will fit perfectly in the storage box. Here I'm putting two of the embossing folders in a pocket, but you don't have to use the pockets for your embossing folders, nor do you have to use the pockets for your dies. You can just stick those embossing folders and the long background dies just right here in the storage box to keep them all together. So here are some slimline cards that I made. You can also use these boxes just to store your slimline cards. So you might want to have one box for your dies, one box for your cards. If you had a lot of stencils, a box for your stencils, or if you don't have that many, you can just store everything in one box. So I want to show you that the scrapbook.com slimline storage envelopes, which is what you see here, these also fit perfectly inside of the Totally Tiffany slimline storage box. So you can mix and match if you have some of the scrapbook.com storage envelopes or if you had some of the Totally Tiffany tab divider pockets. They all fit perfectly in this storage box. And I also want to mention that the scrapbook.com storage envelopes do have a closure, whereas the Totally Tiffany tab divider pockets do not. They are open at the top. And I will link a video at the top right showing the scrapbook.com slimline envelopes in case you're interested. You could also use your storage box to store your slimline paper pads. Here I have all of the scrapbook.com slimline paper pads in this box, and it does fit a lot of them. So any of your slimline paper pads should fit in here. This box measures 10 inches wide, and it also measures 5 inches tall and 3.5 inches deep. So you can fit a lot of stuff in these boxes. So here I'm just showing you how you can take this and you can use the handle and you can carry it around. If you need to bring stuff to a crop or if you're traveling, you can put everything in the box and tote it around. If you use traveler's notebooks for planning or memory keeping, the traveler's notebook inserts fit perfectly inside of this storage box. So you can store them all in here. You can see that I have the smaller size and then the larger size. I have the standard insert and then the standard wide insert. They both fit in this box. In addition, the actual traveler's notebook that I have here will fit in this box, and I can store all of these together. So if you are interested in any of these products, I will have links for these products down in the description box below, so you can head on down there and take a look at that. Thank you so much for watching, everyone, and have a great day. Bye-bye.